हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर एम एच अन्नैया एंड इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू हैव द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द लैटरल सरफेस ऑफ ए पेंटागोनल पिरामिड व्हिच इज कट बाय ए सेक्शन प्लेन व्हिच इज नॉर्मल टू बोथ एच एंड बी एच पी एंड बी बी. नाउ लेट मी शो दिस सॉलिड एंड देन अ सेक्शन प्लेन विल थिंक ऑफ. This is a pentagonal pyramid having this side AB equal to 30 mm. The vertical height of the solid measured from O, the vertex, till the center of the base of the bottom is the axis, which is equal to 60 mm. It is resting on its base on HB. This complete A, B, C, D, E is the base, and it is placed such that one of the short heads, say AB, is normal to VP. So obviously on the other side this will be perpendicular, and on the right extreme end you will be seeing a corner of this. So to start with, let us draw the projections of the solid, keeping the solid on HP such that one of the shorter edge AB is normal to VP, obtain the top and front views. As you see, whenever any of the pyramids are placed on HP, in the top view, it is possible to see the complete base of the solid. So here, we get a regular pentagon of side 30 mm when it is placed with AB normal to VP. And in the front view, you will be able to see 1, 2. These two triangles you will be able to see. So let me start the problem by drawing the projections of the solid. That is, let us obtain the top and front views of the solid. Hence, let me mark the XY line, VP and HP, and then let me obtain the top view of this pentagon when it is placed with one of the shorter edges normal to VP. This is the side AB, and these are the other two sides, and I am very sure you know how to construct this. So here I am just marking this side as AB, and this side measures 30 mm. I just mark it 30 mm is the size of the, and then this is point C, this is point B, and this is point E, and this interior angle is 108 degrees because this is 72. 360 divided by 5 will give you 72, and this angle is 72 degrees here. So this will be 108. So here this side is perpendicular to this. Then after getting this figure, ABCD represents the top view of the base of the pyramid. Obtain the vertex by bisecting L2 adjacent sides. So this is one side, this is the other side. So probably we get this axis here, which I mark as O, O1. O is the center of the O is the vertex, and O1 is the center of the bottom pin. Let me join all these to the corners. One corner, join second, this is third, this is fourth, and this is fifth. This complete figure will give you the top view of the pentagonal pyramid. And here, let me obtain the axis of the solid by a line like this. This is the axis of the solid. The height of the solid is given to be 60 mm. I mark this as O dash, and the height of this solid is 60 mm. Or the length of the axis is 60 mm, and have marked the dimension here. The bottom of center is O1 dash. I just mark here. This is O1 dash, O dash. Then this point is AB. So let me mark A dash, B dash. A dash, B dash is one of the edges. This is C and E, will get somewhere here. This is D on this line. So let me join the vertex to all the corners of the base. So I am joining OA, OB, and this is OC, OE, the base of the solid in this line. So this is a dash b dash, this point is c dash e dash, and this is d dash. Friends, you please notice that this line at OD is parallel to VP, and hence this will give you the true length of this slanted, which I marked as R, which is going to be used for the purpose of drawing the development of the lateral surface. This O dash to D dash is the true length of this slant edge. So all the five slant edges will have the same true length. Now friends, after obtaining the front and top views of the solid, we have to obtain the position of the section plane. In the question he says, the object in this position is cut by a section plane which is normal to both HP and VP. What does it mean? Means suppose you have a section plane like this. This section plane is perpendicular to VP, wherein you see this as a line in the front view and is also perpendicular to HP. This is perpendicular to HP. So again in the top view, you see it as a line. So keep in your mind that whenever any solid is cut by a section plane which is normal or perpendicular to both HP and VP, you are going to see that as a line both in the front view and also in the top view. So at what distance it is, he has given. And at a distance of 15 millimeter from the axis of the pyramid. So we have the axis here. I am going to make a section plane, a vertical line here, at the same distance from the another line. So I am going to mark the section plane at a distance of 15 millimeter from the axis. Axis is OO1. I will take 15 mm from here and mark a section plane here. So this section plane is cutting the base edge here, and it is also cutting the slant edge OD. So I will call this as SS. Similarly, I continue that section plane and say it is cutting the base edges and also this point on the slant edge OD. So I will mark the section plane as SS. SS is the section plane which is normal to VP and is also normal to HP. Hence, it is seen as a line in both the top and front views. After obtaining the position of this section plane at a distance of 15 millimeter, I will mark here from the axis it is 15 millimeter. Here too, here is 15 millimeter. I just look at the front view and mark the portion of the solid that is retained for the purpose of the development. So friends, here this portion is retained, the longer edges are retained here, these are also retained till here. This is also visible, and hence I show by a line inclined here. Only this part is removed. I mark this as P, the portion retained for the purpose of development, and this is the part that is removed from the section plane to the right. This small part is removed. Now coming to the development, friends, let us assume that the solid is not cut by any section plane, and hence in the development you are going to have five triangles. Since it is a pentagonal pyramid, all these five triangles are all isosceles triangle. So before that, already we have marked R, the true length of the slant edge of the pyramid. So I will just mark here the true length, the length, a vertical line say, of radius R, that is the true length. I will mark this as O, the vortex of the solid, the center O, and this R as radius. I am going to draw an arc. So you can just write like this. And here friends, on this arc, this sector, I am going to mark five edges, that is AB, BC, CD, DE and AA, each having 30 mm radius. So from here, using the compasses, 30, 30, 30, 30 and 1 more. Say this is 30. So these are 30 mm each, 30, 30, 30 and so on. So it is a pentagon. If it is a hexagon, we will be adding one more. So let me join this last point to the point here and join all these by very thin line to start with. This all to be joined to the vertex. And from here, you know, all these base edges are straight edges. So I am going to have this by thin line, joined like this. Thin line to start with later on. After this solid is cut, let's see how to get the development. Friends, you can see very well here. Excepting a small portion of OD and a portion of the base, all other slant edges are intact. They are not removed by the section plane. So, for a small change compared to the previous problem, I would like to start the development from OD. And even if you start from OA, OB, OC or OE, there is nothing wrong. Because the small portion is being removed. Let me start with D. So, if you are starting with D, this is E, then L, then F, you can get D, E, then A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. And each of these is equal to 30 mm. 30, 30, etc. So friends, this is R, and this is also equal to R, the length. All these will have the same length or the true length. Now we have got the development of the pentagonal pyramid without being cut. So it is not cut by section plane. Now after it is cut, let us see where all it is cutting. Friends, the section plane which is normal to both HP and BP, that is SS, is cutting the base edges, namely CD and ED. CD and ED at this distance. So you can measure the distance from D like this or from here. So let us say I am taking the distance from D. On D, take this distance at the base and mark. On D, nearer to D, say. On D, nearer to D. I just take the distance and mark on that edge. Similarly, on DC, nearer to D, same distance. On DC, nearer to D. So I will take this as the point. These are the two points where the section plane is cutting the base edges. And it is cutting one more, that is, it is cutting the slant edge OD at this point. And remember, this OD is cut here. OD is the true length. And simply take this distance, that is, the distance from here to here on OD. OD, I just mark it. So on OD, I will take the distance and mark. OD, OD, both the sides. Friends, we have 4 points. 2 points on the base edge and 2 on the slant edge. Now, the points obtained are to be joined by straight lines. And you can see here, the line OA, OB, OC, OE, they are all intact. So before that, let me join them. So this is intact, this is intact, and here you got OA, OB, OC, OE, all are retained. So I am going to show them by full line. So I will join O to C, O to B, O to A, O to E. And the portion above that is also available. So I will just mark this portion straight, this portion straight. And here, what is left over? The last and the base edges I told you, excepting this for the small portion, all the other portion, all other portion is retained. So let me show by dark line, so that we will have clear concept about the edges that are retained for development. I think this will give you a better idea. So this part, small part is thrown out and this all retained. Let me number them. I will number this as 1, 2, 3 and this point is again 1 because 1 and 1 they are OD and the base is intact. As I told you, join these shorter edges of the base by straight line. So all these to be joined by straight line. What is removed? The portion at the end, this small portion and this small portion are removed. When this is removed, this doesn't exist. This line is also removed. This line is also removed. And this figure, friends, will give you the complete development of the lateral surface of the pentagonal pyramid when this is cut by a section plane which is normal to both HP and VP. Now I will just mark here. This will give you the development of P, the part that is retained. Friends, I am very sure that you have followed this development very clearly, and hence if you are happy with this presentation, please subscribe and share the information with all your friends. I thank you all. Have a nice day. And this is Dr. M. H. Annaiah signing off.